Senator Paul, you do not know what you are talking about, quite frankly, and I want to say that officially. You do not know what you are talking about.
You're the Attorney General of the United States. This was not a tweet you sent. This is a memo to the Federal Bureau of Investigations saying, go investigate parents as domestic terrorists.
That is not what the memo says at all. It does not.
Is it what the letter says?
That is not what.
Is it what the letter says?
I don't care what the letter says.
You don't care. You said it was the basis of your memo. You testified under oath before the House of Representatives. The letter was the basis of your memo. Now you don't care about the letter?
The letter and public reports of violence and threats of violence. My memo says nothing about domestic terrorism, says nothing about parents committing any such things.
Not being gain of function. So what was, let me finish.
You take an animal virus and you increase its transmissibility to humans,
right.
You're saying that's not gain of function?
Yeah, that is correct. And Senator Paul, you do not know what you are talking about, quite frankly. And I want to say that officially. You do not know what you are talking about.
Let's
okay, you get
NIH,
one person.
Let's read from the NIH definition of gain of function. How you can say that is not gain of function.
It is not.
It's a dance, and you're dancing around this because you're trying to obscure responsibility for 4 million people dying around the world from a pandemic.
And let's send Dr. Fauci.
I have to, well, now you're getting into something. Let me finish.
We don't know.
Well,
we don't
wait
know
a minute.
If it did come from the lab, but all the evidence is pointing that it came from the lab, and there will be responsibility for those who funded the lab, including yourself.
I totally
this committee
resent,
will allow the witness to respond.
I totally resent the lie that you are now propagating, Senator. It is molecularly impossible.
No one's saying those viruses caused it.
It is molecularly.
No one is alleging that those viruses caused the pandemic. What we're alleging is that gain of function research was going on in that lab and NIH funded it.
That is not.
Can't get away from it. It meets your definition and you are obfuscating the truth.
I'm not obfuscating the truth. You are the one.
Time is expired, but I will allow the witness to
finish. Let me just finish. Those viruses are molecularly impossible
to
result in SARS-CoV-2.
Viruses caused the pandemic. We're saying they are gain-of-function viruses because they were animal viruses that became more transmissible in human, and you funded it.
And you
admit the truth.
And you implying.
Senator Paul, your time has expired, and I will allow witnesses who come before this committee to respond.
And you are implying that what we did was responsible for the deaths of individual. I totally resent
that.
And if anybody is lying here, Senator, it is you.
As recently as yesterday, somebody in the White House has authority to press the button and stop the president, cut off the president's speaking ability and sound. Who is that person?
I think anyone who knows the president, including members of this committee, knows that he speaks very clearly and very deliberately for himself. No one else does.
Well, are you saying that there is no one in the White House that can cut him off? Because yesterday that happened, and it's happened a number of times before that. It's been widely reported that somebody has the ability to push the button and cut off his sound and stop him from speaking. Who is that person?
There is no such person. Again, the president speaks for himself, makes all of the strategic decisions, informed by the best advice that he can get from the people around him.
You've cited, as the basis for that directive, the National School Board Association's letter of September 29th. Was that directive being prepared before September 29th, before the School Board Association letter was issued?
I don't believe so. Certainly, I didn't have any idea.
So it was only prepared at, okay, I think that answers the question.
I already answered that question.
So you keep citing the school board letter and news reports.
That's
news
right.
One of the news reports cited in that letter, which you presumably mean, is from Loudoun County, Virginia.
No, that's
Scott,
not. That is not what I was talking about.
Well, you keep citing news reports, and that's the most prominent news report that anyone in America has seen. That refers to Scott Smith, whose 15-year-old daughter was raped. She was raped in a bathroom by a boy wearing girls' clothes, and the Loudoun County School Board covered it up because it would have interfered with their transgendered policy during Pride Month. And that man, Scott Smith, because he went to a school board and tried to defend his daughter's rights, was condemned internationally. Do you apologize to Scott Smith and his 15-year-old daughter, Judge?
Senator, anyone who's child was raped as the most horrific crime I can imagine, and is certainly entitled and protected by the First Amendment to protest to their school board about this.
But he was cited by the School Board Association as a domestic terrorist, which we now know. That letter and those reports were the basis for your judgment.
No, Senator, this is shameful.
Judge, this is shameful. This testimony, your directive, your performance is shameful.
Okay. That's not correct.
Thank God you are not on the Supreme Court. You should resign in disgrace, Judge.
Do you agree that 61 different federal and state courts, including 8 judges that Donald Trump appointed himself to the federal bench, have rejected every claim of electoral corruption or fraud that have been advanced? Do you agree with that?
I don't. And the reason is those claims are not evaluated because in many of the circumstances you reference, jurisdiction was the principal question. So I think it requires a review of the procedure.
Do you have any case authority in the land of those 61 cases or any other cases where a court has determined that there was electoral corruption or electoral fraud that materially affected the outcome of an election in any state in the union?
No court, do you have one? Which I believe is a real failure of the judiciary. I think the Article III courts failed our country by not exercising more jurisdiction over those questions. Now, there's a difference in whether or not fraud existed and whether or not there's an adequate remedy. And I think also a number of those cases were kicked on remedies.
Well, no court has said that fraud existed, and so there's no remedy because there's no violation, Mr. Gates.
Right, but you cannot.
There's no violation. There's no fraud.
Decided that there was no fraud if they didn't take up the question and review the facts on jurisdiction or remedy.
You know what? That might work on Steve Bannon's podcast, but that's not going to work in the Rules Committee of the United States House of Representatives. I'm sorry, Mr. Gates. Forgive me.